Well, hello everybody, and welcome to Jeff's Baking Blog. Today I'm going to be making Dundee cake. Now, this is going to be my cake for Christmas instead of a traditional Christmas cake. Dundee cake is a cake which is eaten at this time of year as well, and it's similar to Christmas cake in that it has lots of fruits in it, but you don't ice the top. Instead, you cover the top with blanched almonds. And so it takes quite a while to bake, because you bake it at one temperature and then you lower the oven and bake it for a further amount of time until it's fully baked. Now, I've actually lined and greased. This is a 7-inch cake tin, and I've done 7 inches simply because it's the depth I want, but 8 inches would work fine as well. And you want to have a removable base with that if you possibly can. It makes it easier for getting the cake out. And for the ingredients, I have 180 grams, which is 1.5 sticks of softened butter. Then I have 180 grams of soft brown sugar. You could use caster sugar or granulated sugar, but the soft brown sugar gives it a slightly richer flavour, I think. I have 225 grams, 1¾ cups of plain flour, and I have 100 grams, 1 cup of ground almonds, and 1 teaspoon of baking powder. I have 3 large eggs, which would be extra large in the USA, and I've beaten those. Then I have 3 tablespoons, which actually works out at 75 grams of marmalade. You could use apricot jam. Now, I'm using marmalade, and particularly I'm using Dundee marmalade, because this is a Dundee cake and marmalade actually originated in Dundee. I have 100 grams of blanched almonds for the top, which I may not need all of. And then for the fruit, I have here 400 grams of fruit, which is 300 grams of sultanas and raisins of differing types, and 100 grams of currants. And what I did was I soaked those for a few hours in some black tea. You could soak them in whiskey or just in water. That's just to plump them up. Then I've let those drain for over an hour now, just to get that liquid out of them. I have 100 grams, that's 14 ounces of those fruits there. I have 100 grams, which is 3.5 ounces of chopped mixed peel, and 100 grams, 3.5 ounces of chopped glacé cherries. I'm using Morello glacé cherries, but any will do. And then I have the zest of 1 orange as well. So the first thing to do is to cream the butter and the sugar together. I'm going to do this in a large bowl. So you just want to cream those together, and I'm going to use my hand mixer. You could do it by hand if you wanted to. Sorry, I should have told you, I have my oven preheating at 180 Celsius. That's 160 Celsius with a fan, 350 Fahrenheit. And that's the first temperature we use for baking. And with those cream together, I'm going to add the eggs just a little bit at a time and mix them round. If they start to curdle, I'll drop in a little bit of the flour and that will help them. But if they curdle, it doesn't matter because it all comes together later anyway. And with that mixed in, the eggs to the butter and sugar, I'm actually going to add in the orange zest, and I'm going to mix that around as well. So that's good. I forgot to mention that I also have 2 tablespoons, 30 millilitres of milk, which I'll be using shortly. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put the baking powder into the flour, and I'm just going to use a little whisk to mix that in. And I'm going to put the almonds in as well and mix those around. Then they will be ready to go into the mixture very shortly. So the next thing is the marmalade or the apricot jam, and we'll mix that round. And with that mixed in, I'm going to put the flour, the almonds and the baking powder in. And I'm going to mix that on slow and then add the milk as well to get it all combined. But I don't want to overmix. So with the flour and the almonds mixed in, I'm going to put the milk in. And that's everything mixed nicely. So the final thing to do is to put our fruits in. And gently stir those around until they're all combined. And with that all combined, we need to put that into our cake tin. And then we want to level that off, and maybe the back of a spoon would be good. And then, with that fairly level, I'm going to take these almonds and I'm going to just drop them in concentric circles around the cake. And you can do as few or as many. You don't want to press these in, because the cake will rise and cover them if you do that. You just want to drop them on the top. And with the cake topped with the almonds, like that, I'm going to put that into the oven, and I'm going to bake it at that 180 Celsius, 160 Celsius with a fan 350 Fahrenheit for 45 minutes. Then I'm going to reduce the heat to 160 Celsius, 140 Celsius with a fan 320 Fahrenheit, and I'm going to bake it for between 60 and 80 minutes until a skewer in the center comes out clean. But I'll be testing it after sort of about 40 minutes of that 60 to 80 minutes, just to check, because I want the center to be a little bit soft, because it will carry on cooking a little bit as it cools down. So once it's baked, I'll come back and we'll make the glaze, and we'll put the glaze on the top. The Dundee cake is now cooked, and I've taken it out of the oven, and mine baked for 80 minutes. And what I've done is I've taken 1 tablespoon of milk and 2 teaspoons of caster sugar, and I've just melted them together so that over a heat. And I'm going to brush that syrup onto the top of the cake, and then I'm going to put it back in the oven for another 3 minutes. That's good. So I'm going to put that in the oven and let it bake for a further 3 minutes. That's going to cook that syrup through onto the top of the cake. Then I'm going to take it out and let it cool completely. And once it's cooled completely, I'll take it out of the tin and I'll show it to you. The Dundee cake has now cooled completely, and I've taken it out of the tin, and this is what it looks like. Now, it looks very good, but I'm not going to cut it. The perceived wisdom is that you should leave it for at least 2 days for the flavour to develop fully. You wrap it up and then put it into an airtight container and leave it for 2 days. But actually, this cake will also keep for weeks, and it's just about 6 weeks till Christmas now, and I'm assured that this will keep for a good 6 weeks if, when it's completely cool, it's wrapped in plastic wrap and then in an airtight container, and it will be ideal for Christmas. So that's what I'm going to do. So I'm not going to cut it and taste it now. I hope you've enjoyed the video. And if you have, please give me the thumbs up below the video and click to subscribe to my YouTube channel. There was one thing I wanted to say about baking this. Because you don't want it to rise very much, one of the things you can do to prevent that is to wrap some brown paper or some paper a couple of times around the outside of the tin and tie it up, and that actually stops the sides of the tins from getting hot too quickly, And therefore cooking the outside of the cake rather more quickly than the inside. And so you can do that, or if you have baking strips, if you've got a baking strip that fits the size of tin you're using, like that, you can soak that and put that on the outside. And that is a good way of trying to prevent the cake from rising. But mine seem to be okay, so I've left it as it is while it was baking. So that's going to be it for this recipe, as I said. Give me the thumbs up and click to subscribe to the YouTube channel. And I'll be back with another video in the very near future. So until then, happy baking.